morning, brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, our Lord. It's a beautiful day that the Lord has made. It's a blessing to be in the Lord. It's a blessing to be alive. It's a blessing to have the abundance of God, our provider. So as you can see, brothers and sisters, yesterday we went to the store, picked up some bread, and this morning it's December 24, 2019, from Jakarta, Indonesia. This is your brother Frank Nevarez, and my wife, Wulan. God bless you, baby. So I just wanted to read a scripture this morning. It's on John chapter 26. John chapter 6, verse 25. And I'm just going to read down to Jesus answered them and said, "Most assuredly I say to you, seek me not because you saw the sign, but because you ate of the loaves and were filled. Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to everlasting life, which the Son of Man will give you, because God the Father has set his seal on him." Then they said to him, "What shall we do that we may work the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in him who he sent." Therefore they said to him, "What sign will you perform then, that we may see it and believe you? What work would you do?" "Our fathers ate the manna in the desert, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." Then Jesus said to them, "Most assuredly I say to you, Moses did not give you the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." Then they said to him, "Lord, give us this bread always." And Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me should never hunger, and he who believes in me should never thirst. But I say to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and the one who comes to me I will by no means cast out. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. This is the will of the Father who sent me, that of all he has given me, I should lose nothing, but should raise it up at the last day. And this is the will of him who sent me, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day." The Jews then complained about him because he said, "I am the bread which come down from heaven." And they said, "Is not this Jesus the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How is it then that he says, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus therefore answered and said to them, "Do not murmur. Among yourselves, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'And they shall all be taught by God.' Therefore, everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except he who is from God. He has seen the Father. Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me has everlasting life. I am the bread of life. Your father ate the manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is the bread which comes down from heaven, that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread which comes down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh, which I shall give for the life of the world. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the bread of life. Praise his holy name. The name above all names, the name of Jesus Christ, the anointed one, the only begotten Son of God. So, brothers and sisters, I was just going to have some coffee. Thank you. And some bread. And start the day in the Word. And I just wanted to start the day with the Lord as we out to every day. Start the day with the Lord. And having some bread, we went to the shopping yesterday. And we just bought some bread, and it was a blessing that we went to the store and got some bread. We got to spend some good time, had a good dinner with my wife out there, and also witnessed a lot of the need in this world, a lot of the deception also. So many celebrating Christmas, and not knowing the true meaning of Christmas. They call it Christmas. It's a Catholic, Roman Catholicism holiday. Saint Nicholas, and also like us, me myself, I used to celebrate Christmas, not knowing the true meaning of Christmas. But the true meaning of the day, it's Jesus was not born on the 24th or the 25th, you know, but so many celebrate the birth of Jesus. And praise the Lord that Jesus came to the world to save sinners, and we all fall short of the glory of God. There's not one righteous. Without the remission of, without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. So Jesus came to save the world from their sins. He came to seek and save that which was lost. So praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. I also wanted to share, if you guys, because I'm in Indonesia, Jakarta, and it's really difficult for me to fellowship with other believers here. They celebrate Santa Claus, and I've been to a couple of services, you know, not too many, but wow, it's just not in the Word, so it's really difficult for me to be around that. We must come out from among them, says the Lord. So I want to read Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 through 25. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother, Mary, was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with a child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you should call his name Jesus. For he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin should be with a child and bear a son, and they should call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Then Joseph, being arose from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Jesus is the reason we celebrate every day, not just the 24th and the 25th. If you celebrate Christmas, God bless you. Seek the truth, for the sun sets free, should be free indeed. We celebrate Jesus Christ alone every day, for he is worthy of all the glory, of all the praise and honor, for he is God. Amen. And also Luke chapter 4 verse 4. It is written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. But Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, man should not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Hallelujah. Man should not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. This is the word of God, brothers and sisters. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Was God, not a God. Jesus is the Word, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Hallelujah. Jesus, God, became flesh and dwelt among us. What a glorious time to be in the Lord, for he is coming soon, brothers and sisters. And just quickly here, I don't want to make this video too long. I want to go to what is it called, James 4:4. Do you have it? So I'm going to start, adulterers and adulteresses, don't you know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. So if you want to be a friend of the world and celebrate worldly, holidays, worldly festivities, pagan festivities, if you want to go on that wide gate, the broad way that is so easy, and want to go with the crowds, and want to just take part in the things of the world and be friends of the world, well, you make yourself an enemy of God. And he calls you adulterers and adulteresses. Don't you know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. I'm going to keep reading. Or do you think that the scripture says in vain, the spirit who dwells in us yearns jealously, but he gives more grace. Therefore, he says, God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Therefore, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to gloom. Humble yourself in the sight of the Lord and he will lift you up. That is James chapter 4, verse 4 through 10. Hallelujah. Well, praise and glory be to God, my brothers and sisters. praise Him, glory be to God, not to Satan claws. Give God the glory, because when we don't give God the glory, Satan gets the glory. So praise and glory be to God. Heavenly Father, I just come before you in the name of Jesus. I humble myself before your mighty hand. Father God, I resist all evil, and I ask for strength to resist evil. I ask for your hedge of protection, Father God, to be upon me this day, to be upon my wife, to be upon our brothers and sisters, that we, Father God, will humble ourselves and be doers of your word as well. For man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds of your mouth, Father God. Of your word, from every word, not just by bread alone. Heavenly Father, I just ask that you open the eyes, open the ears, and open the hearts of the blind, of the deaf, of those that are spiritually dead, Father God, that you will open their eyes, hearts, and ears, and that you will do mighty works in their lives, that they will surrender completely to you and come out of paganism, come out of this world, and be separated from among them, Father God. I just pray for those lost souls, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, Father God, that your name will be glorified, that your name will be magnified among all nations. For you are God, and you are the reason for the season. You are the reason for every day, Lord. Not just on the 24th and the 25th, but every day we give you glory, praise, and honor. And we bless your holy name for who you are. We humble ourselves, and we ask that we may be, Father God, be your bride, may be your children, and be, we must humble ourselves, Father God, and resist the devil, that he will flee away from us, Lord. I just pray all this in the name of Jesus. For Jesus, you are coming quickly. Jesus, we will serve you. Father God, I pray this in the name of your only begotten Son, Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Hallelujah. Heaven or hell, Jesus or Santa Claus? Jesus.
In the morning.
When
I rise in the morning, when I rise in the morning, when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. Can have all this world, just give me Jesus. When I am alone, when I am alone, oh, when I am alone, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You can have all this world, just give me Jesus.
come see this back. Fat guy, they call him Will Santa I Claus, come the Satan die. Claus. Oh, and kids and fathers and mothers bring their kids, come to die. Greet them. Give me Jesus. Satan Claus at the entrance. Jesus. And then to go into the playground, you got the LGBTQ colors.
Jesus. Give me Jesus.
So what a coincidence.
You can have.
If you know the truth, we have discernment. And we know that this playground here, it's evil, it's wicked.
Jesus.
That's the lie that many parents tell their children about Jesus. Satan,
you can have all this
mothers with children.
You can have all this world.
Just give me Jesus every day, for He is good and He's coming soon. That's like bringing your kids and offering up to Satan, the devil, right here. As you can see, this is a mall from Indonesia. While we were going to get some groceries, we decided to come up here and get some coffee. But we don't buy stuff from malls. We're just going to get some groceries at the grocery store. And I thought I made a short video clip and show you guys a little bit of the lies of the devil all around us.